Okay, now let's talk about the taxes. How do taxes work and why is it important for us to register as a business and file our taxes? Hi everyone, this is Charm again from Ready to Adult Philippines, a channel about personal finance, entrepreneurship, and adulting how-tos. For this video, we will be tackling one of my most requested videos, taxes. How taxes work in the Philippines, tax types to consider, understanding your 2303 or BIR certificate, and also the tax table under the train law. In the next video, I will be focusing more on the income tax, specifically for professionals and sole proprietors. So make sure that you subscribe and hit the notification bell so you get notified once that video comes out. So in this video, I want to discuss the basics first before we dive into all the different taxes that you need to file and how to file them. I also have a video here on the different types of income and how they are taxed in the Philippines. So if you're interested in that as well, make sure to check that out after this video. Now, before we jump right into talking about taxes, let me tell you about the different business types. I already talked about it a lot in my previous video, how to register a business, but I want to give you guys a refresher or a reminder. So we have the corporations and partnerships, and those are considered non-individual taxpayers. That basically means that they have a different TIN number than the individuals that own the business. They are considered to have a different juridical personality than their owners. And if you want to know more about corporations and partnerships, then you can check out my previous video. But in this video and in the next few videos, I want to focus more on the individual taxpayers. So those are the sole proprietors and the professionals. Those who register as sole proprietor are usually MSMEs and online businesses. So they are owned by one person only, so thus having the same TIN number. Also, for professionals, they can either be licensed professionals like doctors, teachers, architects, engineers, and etc. Or they can be non-licensed professionals, and those are freelancers, content creators, performers, artists, and etc. So for professionals, I know I didn't cover this in the last video, but basically you can register them through BIR only or the optional mayor's permit or depending on your locale. But I can make a separate video on how you can register as a professional. I know a lot of freelancers are interested, so let me know in the comments below if you want that video as well. Okay, now let's talk about the taxes. How do taxes work and why is it important for us to register as a business and file our taxes? So taxes are money collected by the government from individuals and businesses to boost economic development in our country. So they are used to fund government operations like public hospitals, bridges and highways, public schools, and government workers as well. So the agency responsible for collecting these taxes in the Philippines is called the Bureau of Internal Revenues, or also called the BIR. So you might be wondering, why should I pay my taxes? What are the benefits that I would get from paying my taxes? So simply put, it is your financial credential. And what that means is that you are telling society or the government that you are an earning individual, which brings me to my first point, which is it is also your proof of income. It can be used in different ways, but some examples I can give is that usually, proof of incomes are required or asked for when you are getting your own insurance, when you are applying for a visa, or when you are applying for a loan from institutions. Now, granted, you can get loans by other means like online loan companies or loan sharks or what you call 5-6, diba? But you get them at a really high interest rate because they don't know your capacity to pay because you didn't show a proof of income. That's why the higher risk they have in letting you borrow money, the higher the interest they're also gonna charge the borrowers. And another example is that credit card companies, when you apply for credit cards, also ask for a proof of income. So the ITR is the most common means of showing your proof of income, and that's one of the reasons why it's important to file your taxes. Second point is that you can get bigger orders or you can cater to bigger clients. I also mentioned this in my previous video, but the power of having a registered business, an official receipt, properly filed taxes and financial statements can really get you more clients and more sales in return. Why? Because a lot of these big companies who wants to order from you or get your services, they will be asking for official receipts. They also need to file that in their books because otherwise it seems like a large chunk of money from them just magically disappeared. And the BIR doesn't like that. So being a legitimate supplier and service provider can really bring your business to a whole new level. And another thing is that number three, it can open up new partnerships. Depending on what partnerships you're going into, they usually let you go through an accreditation process wherein they would ask for your certificates and BIR 2303 and etc. where you have to prove that you're a legitimate business. And number four, you are not breaking the law. So needless to say, it's illegal to operate a business or a profession when you are not registered. And the BIR are quite proud of the advancements they have in their data gathering. And instead of hoping you won't get caught, the peace of mind of just registering your business and filing taxes is honestly so much easier. You can avoid open cases and possibly penalties if you just file your taxes annually. Now, I've heard about a lot of professionals that when they get their registration and their OR booklets that they don't really know what to do with them afterwards. And I've also heard a lot of horror stories of professionals getting slapped with really big penalties because they didn't know that they had to file their taxes quarterly and annually. Now let's talk about the different tax types. How do you know which tax types you need to pay attention to and which ones you need to file? Let's go back to your BIR 2303 or the Certificate of Registration, and it looks like this. Every business and professional has a BIR 2303. Majority of the items there are self-explanatory, like the TIN of the business, the name of the business, the date it was registered, and the address. But check the part where it says registered activity or activities. There you will see what types of tax you need to be paying. First, and this is universal, is the registration or renewal fee. This applies to everyone, and we all have to file this every January under BIR Form 0605, and it's 500 pesos per year. And next are the withholding taxes, and I also plan to make a future video about this because there are a lot to unpack. But basically, if you've heard of withholding tax, it's because it's in the interest rates you get from investments and banks, and it's also in your salaries and etc. And there are different types of withholding taxes like compensation, expanded withholding tax, GVAT, and GMP. And something that I want to discuss a little is, I know that majority of the people watching this are individual taxpayers or especially professionals or freelancers. If you're a freelancer and you're an unregistered professional, then the withholding agent, that's the company that's gonna pay you, usually withholds 10%. But if you're a registered professional and you're earning less than 3 million a year, you can actually bring that down to 5%. So contrary to popular beliefs that you will be paying more once you register as a business and file your taxes, you can actually save more, especially if you have a lot of dealings with local clients. The next type of tax is business tax, and this would depend on your gross sales if you are earning more or less than 3 million pesos. So if you are earning less than 3 million pesos a year, you would usually be under the 3% percentage tax. You have to file this quarterly through the BIR Form 2551Q. That's January, April, July, and October. And how you compute this is basically you take your gross sales and multiply it by 3% or 0.03, and that's what you need to be filing quarterly. Now, if you are earning more than 3 million pesos a year, then you are what we call VATable, or you will be charged value-added tax or the 12% sales tax that we're mostly familiar with. Now, you have to file this monthly through the 2550M or Q BIR forms. And how you compute for this is basically you get the output tax and you deduct the input tax. That's basically the VAT from all your income minus the VAT from all your expenses. So I'll also link to good articles and to BIR sample computations down below if you guys are interested to know more. Now, something I want to stress, and I've encountered this a lot of times, is a lot of non-VAT businesses actually add VAT to their final price. I've encountered this in a lot of the services specifically that I've hired for my business. So again, go back to your BIR 2303. If you are not required to file for value-added tax, then don't charge your customers and your clients VAT as well. Okay, now we're down to our last type of tax, and this is the income tax. And I think this is the one that we're most familiar with because of the April 15 and ITR and income tax return season that's very popular every year. So there's actually a type of income tax wherein you don't have to file for business taxes anymore. That's what we mentioned, the 3% percentage tax. But there are some conditions, of course. So this is the 8% flat income tax rate. So the 8% tax rate is a new tax schedule that was implemented during the Train Law of 2018. You need to file this on April, May, August, and November. So if you did not express that you wanted the 8% flat income tax rate, then you are usually automatically in the percentage tax with the graduated income tax rate. I'll be talking about that next. But basically, you can't start this 8% flat rate during the middle of the year. You have to finish filing your annual income tax return first, and then you can express in the first quarter, which is filed on May, that you will be adapting the 8% flat rate instead. Also, this only applies if you are earning less than 3 million pesos. And how you compute this is basically you get your gross sales and you deduct 250,000 pesos from that. I'll be talking more about this later and in the next video. But once you get that is you multiply that by 8% or 0.08. And from that, you get your tax payable. So again, if you are in the 8% flat income tax rate, you don't have to file for 3% percentage tax anymore or 2551Q. Next type of income tax is the graduated income tax rate, and there are two ways to compute for that. First is through itemized deduction. You get your gross sales, you manually list down all your expenses, that's why it's called itemized. You get your taxable income from there, and you would refer to the graduated tax table. I'll talk more about the graduated tax table in a bit. And you have to remember that with itemized deduction, you have to keep the receipts for at least 10 years. But basically, that's the first way to deduct your expenses. Another way is called the optimized standard deduction. For the OSD, only 60% of your gross sales will be taxable. 40% goes directly to your expenses. Now you might be wondering which is better for me, itemized deduction or optimized standard deduction. You have to assess that for yourself, but the rule of thumb is you can opt for the itemized deduction if you have higher overhead costs, like for example, you're into buy and sell. Now it is advised that you go for the optimized standard deduction if you have higher margins or if you have lower costs, especially if your costs are lower than 40% of your sales. So, for example, people in the service industry, like freelancers who have lower overhead costs because maybe they're working from home. Lastly, let's talk about the income tax table or the graduated tax table. I've mentioned this a couple of times, but let me show you what it is. This is basically what it looks like. It was implemented in the Train Law of 2018, and this particular table is valid from 2018 to 2022. After 2022, from 2023 onwards, this tax table will be implemented. Now, I was finding ways how to simplify explaining the tax table. I made this meter over here, and basically, if we're gonna base it on the current tax table, this one, if your taxable income is 0 to 250,000 pesos, then you don't have to pay for additional taxes. You just have to file them. Again, you have to file them even if you are not paying for anything. Now, as you earn more and more, anything after the 250,000 pesos taxable income, you will be taxed 20%. Now, if your taxable income is 400,000, that's 30,000 pesos. Anything after that is gonna be taxed 25%. Now, if you have a taxable income of 800,000 pesos, that's automatically 130,000 pesos in taxes. And anything after that is taxed 30%. If you have a taxable income of 2 million pesos, that's automatically 490,000. Anything after that is taxed 32%. And at 8 million of taxable income, that's automatically 2.41 million. And anything in excess is taxed at 35%. Okay, so I hope that was clear. I'll be talking more about the tax table and the computations in the next video. Okay, Now, I know that registering your business and understanding taxes can be overwhelming. But once you understand the concept and how it works, you will realize na kaya naman pala, diba? And as citizens of this country, it is our duty to abide by these laws and therefore file our taxes properly. Now, I acknowledge that filing taxes and all of these things can be complicated. That's why I personally reached out to Taxumo to partner with them. Taxumo is a web application and it is the easiest way for small business owners, self-employed professionals, and freelancers in the Philippines to prepare, file, and pay their taxes. I think the service they provide is great, especially for individual taxpayers. You can sign up to Taxumo for free to check out their services, and if you do want to avail of their services, like literally they will be the one to file your taxes for you and almost everything is automated, then you can subscribe to their service. I got you guys a 10% discount when you use the code ReadyToAdultPH. Now, this is not a sponsored video, although I am an affiliate of Taxumo now, and I will be talking more about Taxumo in the next video. Please like this video if it made you understand taxes a little bit more. I know I haven't uncovered everything just yet. There's a lot of things to discuss about taxes, but I hope you subscribe also to the channel so that you can watch my next few videos about taxes. Taxes are part of adulting after all, and I know that adulting can be hard, and that's why I love making these videos for you guys. Again, this has been Charm from Ready to Adult Philippines, and I will see you on my next video. This is the... You will... Whatever.
Don't touch my tripod! No!